Okay, let's go.
Staircase.
Yeah.
That's a staircase.
Hey Gary, let's first go here.
Well, I'd rather go to the toilet.
Oh yes, go to the toilet. We'll meet here again in about 2 minutes, okay? It is? Wow.
Huh?
Wow. Now this is absolutely impressive.
Something about
British Museum. Okay, let's go. Okay, I want the Roman ones, I want the Greek ones, but most of all, I want the Egyptian ones. If I'm not mistaken, Tutankhamun is here, right?
Yeah.
I want to see him. I'll wait for you. God bless you. Come on, Gary. Gary, looks like the History Museum in Cairo. That's exactly how it looks like. Just imagine all those monuments surrounding you. The museum even bigger than this one.
Rosetta Stone?
Yeah.
The Rosetta Stone.
Yeah. It's the Rosetta Stone! Yeah. This way. Oh, so, excuse me. Sorry. Got it. My bad. Their energy not a thing, Gary. Their energy flows. They're real. They're all real. It must be Ramses. Let's see. I knew it. Ramses the second. These are some of the oldest sarcophagus. Stone ones and granite. I can't believe we've never been here. These are guardians. They are used to stay in front of the temple. One side and another. That's Bastet, the cat goddess. Yeah.
I know what this is.
Yes.
The rejuvenation thing.
Exactly. Where sarcophagus is placed. Yeah.
That's amazing, isn't it?
Stargate.
Yes.
Was. That must be. I don't know who this one is. I think it's Osiris. No, it's Isis. Sheshonk. Come, Gary, we have much to see. Very impressive people, the Syrians. If it wasn't for the Egyptians, perhaps they would have been the most impressive of them all. The most impressive people of them all. Nimrod. The palace of Nimrod. Speaking of which, they hunted lions. These hieroglyphs represent a complete and descriptive representation about they having to hunt lions. So they would be able to take transportations of precious cargo, like food and supplies. You see here, mules carrying all sorts of supplies, but they were in danger because lions used to roam here. So that's why they had to hunt them down, so they would clear the way.
So they didn't do it for sport?
Of course not. In fact, they actually worshipped lions. Told you. These depictions indicate that their ruler, the king, after the hunt was done, actually made it official.
Look how detailed it is.
Yes. Can you believe that this is about 5,000 years old?
They've been kept in the right conditions. That's the point. If this were anywhere else in the world,
yes,
it would be mostly destroyed.
Yes. How could they maintain such well-preserved stones? Well, these are actually stones. Very fragile, especially during time. Oh, this is how they did it. First, they shot arrows at them. And afterwards, they would throw spears at them. And last but not least, they would have the finished touch, chopping their throats off with swords and even axes. How meticulous. Just as I expected, the king himself attended this hunt. See how heroically he is depicted here. Although most of the work was done by his soldiers, his best champions. Poor lions. You know why there were so many? Because, you know, lions hunt in pack. So the lions must have attacked them in full numbers. But humans being so well organized and so well armed, well, the lions had no chance against them. But they did fight, and the lions were the ones who attacked first.
Okay, let's move it on. It's a big museum.
Yeah.